In this tutorial, I'll show you how to zoom to certain areas of the video using the anchor point. Let's get to it. Here we are in Premiere. I've got this video as the example. So once you have your video on the timeline, you want to click on it so it's highlighted, then head over to the Effect Controls panel. And here under the Motion section, you will find Position, Scale, Rotation, Anchor Point settings. And the one we need is the anchor point. So if we click on the word anchor point, then you will see this blue cross or the blue target in the middle of the program monitor. And this is the anchor point, so think of it as the origin of the layer. So any animations that you apply from here will be originating from this point. So let me go ahead and increase the scale, and you will see that we're zooming into the area where the anchor point is. So this way we can place this anchor point to any area in the video, and then just keyframe the scale to zoom into that part. But it could be a bit tricky while moving this anchor point, because if we start dragging the values in the anchor point, you will see that entire video is moving. And that is not exactly what we want. The trick here is that first you want to click on the anchor point so you can see the anchor point in the program monitor. And then you want to physically click and drag this point and place it wherever you want. So as I'm dragging it, you will see that the position is also changing relative to the anchor point. So that is why the video stays in place. So let me go ahead and place it to this white car. And then find the moment where you want the zoom to begin. So let's say here, I'm going to create a keyframe for scale by clicking on the stopwatch, then move 1 second forward, and then simply increase the scale to something like 250. So now if we go ahead and do the preview, we will be zooming just to the area where we've placed the anchor point. And then you can also create the same zoom out animation by maybe going a bit forward, then create a hold keyframe by clicking this add remove keyframe, then move another second forward, and then click on reset parameter for the scale to zoom out. So we'll have the zoom in. It'll stay like that for some time, and then it will zoom out. And now let's say you have a very long video like mine, where you would want to zoom to different parts of the video throughout the timeline. So you could either go ahead and create separate keyframes for position and the anchor point and also the scale, or you could do something very simple. So first select the eraser tool and then create a cut in the video wherever you want to, say here. Then switch back to the selection tool. So here I've divided the video into two separate pieces. So this one is where we've zoomed into this white car. So let's say here I want to zoom to this red car down here. So I can do the same thing. Make sure you click on the video on the timeline so it's highlighted, then head over to the Effect Controls panel, and again click on the word anchor point, and it should be placed up here where we've previously placed it on the white car. So I'm just going to click and drag it and place it on top of the red car, and we're going to keyframe the scale the same way we did previously. But first we need to undo the previous animation keyframes by clicking on the stopwatch, then click OK to remove the existing keyframes, and then click on the stopwatch again to create a new keyframe, then move like a second forward, and again zoom in to say maybe 250%, and we're zooming into this red car. So now if we do the preview of the whole thing like here, so here we're zooming into the white car, then it stays like that for some time, then it zooms back out, and then in the next part we are zooming to a different car. And you can just create some multiple cuts like this and zoom to different parts of the video. So that's the technique I wanted to share with you. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.